here on my screen, I have a finished regular report. And you'll notice that there are some filters here where a user can choose to optionally search and filter the report data set on a salesman number, a customer number, or a ship month. Now, these are text inputs, so to make this more usable for my end user, I'm going to go ahead and put some drop-down list on here. That way, nobody has to key in the value they want to search on. So I'll start this by going to my MPainter editor, and I'll find that first runtime value prompt filter. That's a filter on salesman number. Click inside that input and select my insert option list button on the right hand side. From this window, I'll specify where the data for this list will come from, whether that's a data model, an Empower application, specifically the Web 2.0 option list retrieval. I can query the reports of the current app to get a distinct list of values, or I can optionally make a static quick list where I key in the values for the drop-down list. For the sake of this first filter, I'll create a data model over my salesman data. Now, this data model, this is what you heard me call a dictionary level data model. I can select an existing one from here, or I can create one on the fly, which I'll do right now by saying create new model. And this model, it will be a salesman model, and this will be very similar to building an Empower application. This data model will utilize my salesman information there, and I'll select any fields I want in this model. In particular, I just need the salesman number, and in this case, I'll also take the salesman name, okay? Making sure the salesman number, that's the field my filter in the report is looking for. It's the salesman number. Now, here in field settings, specifically because this data model will be used as a dropdown, I'm going to indicate that the salesman number from the model be the value my dropdown filters on, and the name will be what I actually show in the dropdown to the user. So the user can see the name, but the report will filter on the number. In dimensions, I'll go ahead and sort by the salesman name and just proceed all the way to the end here and specify, now that I've created the model, to proceed with it. And this takes me right back to where I was in MPainter, where I can just say, go to my list configuration, and if I want a drop down or buttons, I can specify that here, right? And I'll go ahead and press save. And visually in the MPainter editor, I can see a drop down list has been inserted there. I want to apply a similar concept to my customer number runtime value prompt filter here. And I want a drop-down list, and just like I did before, I don't want a list of customer numbers to display. I want to put the customer name or some descriptive value the user can see. But applying the drop-down is going to be the same way, where I insert the option list. This time I'll select an Empower application and utilize a pre-built Web 2.0 option list retrieval that I have made. So unlike the dictionary data model, this is a specific retrieval that I've already pre-configured. And like before, I can specify my list style and change the blank option text right there. Lastly, my ship month filter right now is expecting the user to type in a value between 1 and 12. So to make this easier to use, I'll insert the option list. I'll click the insert option list feature again. However, this time, I don't have a table like the data model and Empower application route would want that has a list of, let's say, each month name. And by using the quick list feature here, I can create my own list of months. And specifically in this list, I'll have each option value and each option text, which you can think of this as the value that I'm going to filter on the left-hand side. And then the right-hand side is the value, or really the description that gets shown to the user. So here I'm just making my own list. And once I'm done with the list, I can reorder any of the options if I want them to display such as maybe in alphabetical sequence. But once I'm done, I'll save my quick list. And this list is selectable now. Like I mentioned, not just in this app, but any application I want to utilize this list, I can do that. And now I finally have a drop-down list on all my filters in this report. Finally, I'll just save my MPainter work, run my application, and right away I can see those drop-downs are here. And visually, I can see that I'm showing the salesman name here, but knowing that behind the scenes, because I configured the data model that way, it's going to pass the number of the selected salesman. So if I select Cassandra Townsend, and then go ahead and select a customer, same concept. I'm showing the name, but behind the scenes, it will pass the number. Okay. And lastly, let's also look at a month, 1 month of sales for this salesman and customer. I'll go ahead and get that information there. And I can see, sure enough, as I mentioned, the appropriate number, the list value has been passed to the filters. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video on creating dropdowns in MPainter.